Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Fallout 4. My name is Brian, your host and commentator, and I actually lied. We're not going to do the Battle of Bunker Hill this episode. Instead, we are going to do... Where's Bioscience? We're going to do a side quest. Here we go. We are going to be doing a side quest. This episode, there are a couple of side quests actually we can do. I think there's only two. Maybe there's three. I don't know. There's like two or three. Not a whole lot of side quests though, but we're going to go ahead and clear one of them up this time. We got to find the right guy. Not generic institute scientists, that's for sure. I wonder what time it is too. Might need to wait. Is there a chair? I think that scientist was sitting in the only chair. Because there's like no one in here. Alright, up you go. Come on. Let's get up. Come on. Get up! Yeah, no problem, pal. Okay, so there's no other seats. Maybe there's one in here. There's got to be one around here somewhere. Come on. Yeah, thank you. Jeez. So you got to sit down to wait. Which I kind of do like. 11:08 p.m. All right, let's set it for... We'll do 12 hours. We'll put it to 11 a.m. And then hopefully he should be walking around all goofy-like and whatnot like an institute scientist would. Alright. Let's get up and go find this guy. Hey, yo. I think this is the dude with the hair. You gotta talk to the head. You're gonna have to work pretty hard to impress anyone down here. Or maybe it's Isaac.
Well, well. If it isn't our visitor from the past. Some time ago. We covertly replaced
the
patriarch at Warwick Homestead with a synth. He's been field testing a variety of genetic...
So that's kind of fucked up, though, what they did there. This packet of seeds to the Roger
Warwick synth. Be careful with these. They represent years of genetic manipulation and enhancement. Hopefully you can manage such a simple task.
Seeds for what?
A melon plant...
Seeds for what?
Calculations are correct. Be able to grow even in heavily irradiated soil. The fruited
berries
are perfectly healthy and edible. Or so I hope. Now listen closely, because this next part is vitally important. When Roger asks how your trip was, tell him some blood bugs chased you halfway across the Commonwealth.
Those damn blood
that
bugs.
Code phrase will identify you as an agent of the Institute. Also, you must be discreet. Do nothing to draw attention to yourself or raise suspicion.
All right.
And if your synth has been compromised?
Then you'll have to improvise. You seem clever. I'm sure you'll manage. Now hurry on to Warwick Homestead so we can begin the experiment.
Okay, man. You don't need to, like, force it on me, bro. Let's go to Warwick Homestead now. Glad I stopped over here earlier just to discover the location. We'll pop in there, and we got a little bit of shenanigans going on, a little running around to do for this quest. Just a little bit. Hopefully we'll have time for a side area as well. But we'll see. We'll see. This isn't like a big quest or anything, so I feel like we will. I don't know. Let's go talk to these guys. Blurry.
Everyone wants a piece of what I got.
Oh yeah, this is one of the dealers.
Got a melting face, but I'm your girl.
I'll take a look, sure.
I think she's got drugs. Or chems. Oh, maybe not. Maybe she has all kinds of shit. Gears, lead, silver, springs. You know what? I will take all those because I feel like I might kind of need them. Alright, let's see. Do you also have... Yes, you do. 90 fusion cells. I'll also take any shotgun shells you have. 47, beautiful. And spray and pray. I like it. Why not? Alright, let's see. What can I sell to you? Spray and pray. Bullets explode on impact. Ooh, that's not bad. Alright. I can sell these. I can sell a bunch of this Radex. Here, I'll sell... Yeah, I'll sell 8 of them. I'll keep 2. Pick one up later. can sell a bunch of this rad away. There we go. I'll keep 5. I think I want to keep all those psycho buff. Alright, I'll sell the jet. Because I have psycho jet. I need to make some more psycho buff. Let me sell all this ammo and try and make some of this money back. Sell 9. I'll just keep 1 fusion core. I'll sell these mini nukes too. Fuck it. Alright. I guess that's good. I'm only losing 1,000. I'll take it. Got a lot of goodies there off that deal. Oh yeah, we gotta switch the quest over too. Alright, Roger Warwick, where are you at? Actually, let's check inside. Just want to show off the interior. There's no magazines or anything to get here, so don't worry about that. Just to show off how cool the interior kind of is. It's a pretty nice area. Like, it's a pretty good spot for them to set up shop, in all honesty. This is also a settlement that you can manage to later on. So, where's he at? There he is. Roger. I hope.
Some blood bugs chased me halfway across the Commonwealth, but I made it.
Yeah, those things can be pretty territorial. Glad they didn't catch you. Since you traveled all this way, how about a quick tour? Right this way, if you please. I'll show you what we've been up to here at the Warwick Homestead.
All right.
We're proud of what.
There's a bird just hanging out.
We've come through some tough times here, I don't mind telling you.
I like the view. Loving the view, actually.
A little elbow grease, you can achieve just about anything. You got the seeds? Good. Well, thank you. Listen, I need your help. The whole operation's in danger of being exposed.
Why? What happened?
I think my foreman, Bill Sutton, suspects what I really am. He's been spying on me and having secret conversations with our farmhand, Cedric. Now, he's starting to work on my wife and kids, trying to turn them against me, too.
Just how dangerous is this foreman? Is he a real threat?
I don't know, maybe. He's heard all the same boogeyman stories as everyone else. A lot of people up here are scared. They're seeing scents around every corner. Anyway, there's more to it. Cedric's banished. Bill says he had to visit a sick relative. But I think he went to get help.
Do you have any idea where Cedric went?
Of course I know. The whole point of their plan was to keep me from finding out. But I have a feeling that someone around here does. If Bill's taking June and the kids into his confidence, he might have told them what he's planning. Right now, they're too suspicious to talk to me about it, but they've got no reason to suspect you. Just remember, Bill's got them all pretty scared. It's not going to be easy.
Alright, discover Bill's plan. I guess we'll talk to these folks.
Sorry,
Wally Warwick.
I'm not supposed to talk to strangers.
Well, I'm not a stranger. I'm a friend of your father's, and I'm here to help him.
Oh, good. I'm really glad you're here, because I'm scared something bad is going to happen to my dad. Foreman Bill said dad's a synth. Looks like a robot. Looks like a real person. Foreman Bill said he had an idea to take care of our synth problem. Gave Cedric some caps and said I'm a good neighbor. I wish they would just leave my dad alone.
Alright, thank you. Hopton, Cedric Hopton. So he's a good neighbor then. Where's Bill at? I want to find Bill.
I'm sorry, but things are
June Warwick, Wally Warwick, Janie Warwick, Roger Warwick. Bill? There's Bill. Is that it? Those are all the people here? Plus that Cedric guy, but he's gone. Ooh, this is cool. I like this. What's over here? Damn it. What the fuck? I did not know about this whole little back area. That's pretty cool. There's a mini nuke. Sweet. Even though I got rid of mine. Duct tape. I might bring my Fat Man along for the end of the game. With all my mini nukes I have stored up. I know I have quite a few of them. What? Souvenir magnet cat? I don't know what that is. Okay, well that was fun. I wonder if there's anything down here. Nope. Okay. Let's fast travel. Oh yeah, I don't think we can fast travel when we're swimming. We're gonna have to get out of the water. Alright. Let's fast travel to Good Neighbor, talk to Cedric, be like, yo, what's up? What are you doing? See what's going on here. Help old Roger out. I don't want to spend too much time here doing this, because I do want to get a side area cleared out. Oh man, this episode's already gone 11 minutes. Might have to do a smaller side area. Is he... Oh yeah, this is the bar. I thought this was like the entrance to the place. I was like, why is he here hanging out with Hancock? Like, what would he get out of that? Or something. I don't know. Let's go. I deal with the drunks. Yo, Cedric. Cedric.
Answer my question. Why did Bill send you here?
I heard you twice the first time, stranger. Thing is, I don't see how any of this is your goddamn business. Unless, tell you what, though. If I've learned anything here, it's that information's got a price. Just like everything else. I got no particular loyalty to Bill Sutton or to Roger Warwick. So make me an offer, and let's see what happens.
I know you're in a tough situation here, but lives are at stake. Please, help me.
Bill isn't the only one.
Bastard.
People all over the Commonwealth are talking about this institute. But maybe you're right. Maybe we are letting that fear get the best of us. Oh, truth is, this whole trip was a damn fool idea, if you ask me. Bill hands me a fistful of caps and says, go to Good Neighbor. They got all kinds of shady characters there. Find us a mercenary. So, I'm supposed to find some contract killer like I know how. And then hire him to take out Roger. First I agreed, but now I'm thinking, to hell with Bill Sutton. I'll just stick around here for a while. Of course, he's probably figured out that I ain't coming back. Might just take matters into his own hands. As frightened as he is,
oh shit,
he's capable of just about anything.
Oh, God. All right. Confront Bill Sutton. Well, oh, yeah, I gotta leave this. Gotta leave. Can't just fast travel from anywhere. No, that'd be way too convenient. Way too convenient. It does take a lot out of the game, though, being able to fast travel like that. Like, I don't know. That was one cool thing about Morrowind, is that you kind of explored a lot, you know, and discovered things as you wandered around. Which is pretty neat. And then Oblivion kind of like came around and I was like, yeah, this fast travel is pretty cool actually. I was enjoying the fast travel in Oblivion. But then, yeah, I kind of also like the non-fast travel aspect of Morrowind. I don't know, Bethesda games are really good regardless. They've been dumbing them down a lot, it seems, in my opinion, but they're still pretty good. Does take away from it. A lot of stuff is very polished about this game. I might like this game more than 3, just because, like, simply because I haven't played this one as much as 3. Or, I mean, I haven't played 3 as much as this one, too. I have not gone through and completed everything in 3. Oh, shit. When you do, this escalated.
So this thing could take his place.
Shit. sure about this. Calm down, drop your weapon.
There's no need for violence here. Let's talk things over.
You're stalling. You're gonna try to talk me down. And then when I'm not expecting it, you'll get the drop on me. Who the hell are you, anyway? I'll tell you who you are. You're one of them! You show up out of nowhere, have your secret chat with Roger, and the next thing I see, you're off looking for Cedric! That's right, I figured it out. I know you're up to something, and I ain't gonna trust a word you say!
Do you really want to leave these children without a father?
Their real father's long gone! And I'm guessing you people had a hand in that. So what do you plan to do, Strength?
If it means protecting innocent people from a madman, yes.
A madman? Is that what you think I am? I know what I've seen. At least, I think I do. What else could explain it? None of you believe me, do you? Am I really crazy? I don't know. I was so sure about Roger. Jesus. What if I'm wrong? What if I was about to, right in front of June and the kids? I have to leave. I'm sorry. I need to sort things out. I've lost sight of things.
Can now use the workshop at Warwick Homestead.
Bill,
woo!
Man once. I don't know what happened to him.
You became a synth. That's what happened to him.
Yeah.
Anyway.
I thought for sure I was a dead man.
What happened to set him off like that?
Bill was already on edge. But Cedric hadn't come back yet, and then you showed up. I guess he figured his time had run out, and he decided to take things into his own hands. You can tell our mutual friends that I'll get those seeds in the ground and have a report ready soon. In the meantime, you'll be safe out there.
Oh, I will. Talk to Isaac, and we're only about like 15 minutes or so into this episode, so that means we got plenty of time to explore a side area. So we got either the Adam Cat's garage, or they might take some time, though. Let's go down to Poseidon Energy. There's a bobblehead and a magazine here that we can get. There's also a bobblehead and a magazine at the Adam Cat's garage. And a little side quest. We'll save that for another time. Next episode, we'll do the Battle of Bunker Hill. And that might take up most of the episode, actually. And then, we'll have a couple of quests that'll be really quick. Not take a whole lot of time, and we'll finish up the side areas at that point. Tired of the same old look. Oh, I didn't get to read all of that tip. Okay, the Peabody House. Here we go. Poseidon Energy, right outside of it. How convenient. And then, of course, we'll talk to Isaac Carlin to finish the quest off. Alright. I'm coming for you, Poseidon Energy. Master Lock. Actually, I wonder if we can we approach it from the top? Let's see if we can get in through the roof. I don't know if we can, but something tells me we can, like this ramp here. Oh jeez, there's a lot of guys here. That's fine though. We need to take care of them. There's a dog. Yeah, let's take care of this dog. Easy. There's quite a few people below me. That's okay though. I'll work my way from the top down. I feel like it's easier that way, plus I have the height advantage, and I don't know. This turret's like, huh? Buff jet. I'll take it. Why not? I'll use it at some point. Get really buff and smart. 32 flares. Wow. This guy had some... Yeah, he had some shotgun shells. So I guess everyone's below me or inside this centralized part. Ouch. Fuck. I don't know where that came from. Fuck you. Alright, I'll pull this out. Oh, legendary raider, hello. Damn, these raiders are kind of strong. Ooh, I don't know if I barely escaped that grenade or what. Oh man, yeah, this is all I'm doing. I'm gonna get up to the, I think tonight I'm gonna record the rest of these Institute quests up until the point where we have to basically decide what faction we are working with. That'll give me plenty of episodes to upload for the next like 10 days or so. I'll probably just play Acrobat's Leather Left Leg. Probably play some Gears of War 4 for the rest of the night. Just chill out. Chilling out, Max, and relaxing. All doing it up. Terminal. Let's see what this terminal does. Outflow access. Alright, well, fuck it. I have master lockpick, so why not? Let's unlock this thing. Nice. See what's inside. Enter Poseidon Energy. So we have a magazine and a bobblehead to get here. And of course, we're on the top level. So I'm not entirely sure. I think they're like kind of on the catwalks and stuff. I don't know. Or maybe they're centralized. We'll be fine. Just kill these guys really quick. One punch to each of them. Taking them down. Man, you know what's great is like playing like Morrowind and like Fallout 3 and like the earlier versions of Bethesda games, you know? Essentially the earlier versions. And then playing these later ones, you're just like, wow, just the improvements. Like, the combat system in this game is smooth as fuck. It's probably the smoothest for a Bethesda game. Skyrim's was pretty good, too. Oh, wow. See, we're already up top where the boss is. Ricochet. There we go. Take care of this armored fucker. Poseidon Energy Key. See, it pays to approach from the top. If you don't have Master Lockpick, I'm not sure entirely how you get in here. Maybe there's another entrance. I don't know. I just saw the bottom one had a master. So I was like, maybe you go through the top. The top had a Master Lock. I don't really know. Glory. Wonder what that all means. Here's the magazine. Tesla Science, which works for me. And the bobblehead. Endurance bobblehead. Woo! Beautiful. I love it. Take care of everything right out the gate. Fuck the bullshit. Now we can just press forward and take care of everyone else and exit through the bottom. Head back to the Institute, turn in this quest, and call it an episode. That's what it sounds like to me. I feel like the Adam Katz garage is going to take up a little more time because there's a side quest associated with it. So we'll kind of hang back and do that one either next episode or actually probably not next episode. The episode after that is probably when we'll get that in. Get this fragmine out of here. Are there any guys left? Did I kill their whole like team, their whole gang? Almost walked right into that. I feel like I might have just killed their whole gang. Right out the gate.
Got it.
Dead. Everyone's done. Here's a Protectron. I don't even need to activate him though because everyone's dead. I did kill everyone. Oh no, there's a turret. That's it, though. Just a turret. It's my only... the only resistance I get in this place. Alright, whatever. Let's explore. Let's just see what's going on. We'll go down here. We'll check out everything. We'll probably dip out really quick. Not a whole lot going on in this place. We got the bobblehead. We got the magazine. That's about as important as anything got here. So cool. Is this the whole bottom area? There is a hole in the wall. Ah, and a frag grenade. And a protectron. Oh, this is maybe this is like the way you're supposed to enter. Through like this mysterious hallway of, I don't know, sewers or something. Here, let me grab. That way I have three Radex. I think that's all I really need. Our protectron's lined up, ready to go. Oh, I have to hack the security terminal. Alright, fine. I'll do it. Stars, stars. Can we style? Nice. Read me. Don't touch anything. Use the roof access. We don't want this floor waking up too. Cuddy. Waking up. The fuck does that mean? Oh shit. Damn, that thing was putting a number on me. That must be this must be the entrance on the bottom then. There's something down there too. Is there a basement? Oh, the Protectrons wake up. Took care of him really quick. Where's the other one? Yeah, I saw two of them. I know there's two of them. Ouch. Oh, is it? Fucking. Oh, those have fusion cells in them. Of course they do. Commencing attack. That dude got blasted. Okay, I think that's all we got here. Oh, there's another Protectron. So is that what happened? All these activated? All the defense systems and robots activated? Is there one in here? Is that it? No more? Alright. Oh. Something just shot at me. I think. I don't know. Let's go around here. Nope, okay. Just the main area. Alright, let's get out of here. Let's go. Actually, we got that ramp, that downwards ramp. Holy shit, I gotta go through here. That, like, ramp that looked like it was by the entrance. Do you remember? What's in here? Oh, yeah, bathrooms. I was already in this area. I must have activated all of the... That's cool. I could have activated them, and they would have fought all the raiders if I would have gone through the bottom. But this was a much easier route, so... Oh, yeah, the sub-levels. Look at that! It's got sub-levels. Okay. I'm fine with that. We'll be in and out of here in no time. Maybe this is actually how you're supposed to enter if you don't have, like, master lockpicking. Go through the sewage system. Fight Meyer Lurks and shit. Oh, shit! Woo! Was not ready for that. Was not ready for that. Looks like I awoke everything. Robotic. Oh my god, really? There we go. There we go. Let's do it. Fuck that technical document. Oh, that was kind of a nasty burp. It tasted like beer. Like Labatt. Blue lime. Apparently certain areas of the U.S. don't get Labatt blue. I was like, really? Because, I mean, I'm in Michigan, so it makes sense that I would get Labatt Blue right next door. I was just like, really? Wow. I was just surprised because I thought it was a lot more, I guess, mainstream, like, throughout the U.S. I guess I was wrong. There's a lot of Mirelurks down here. All right, fuck it. Let's do this. Let's take care of these guys. Oh! Holy shit. Where am I? Oh. That is one dead raider. I should probably get out of the water, though, because I don't think I can fight in here. Ooh, right in the face. Yeah, these face shots on these guys, or these headshots, are dirty. There we go. I was like, sit down, get out of here. This flooded area. But I was like, Mirelurk versus turret. He's like, hey, get over here. You bitch. Let's take care of him. I was like, fuck it. Alright, wow, that was really dark. It's like, you need to let this screen readjust its brightness. A lot of glowing Mirelurks. Which I guess makes sense for the level I'm at. Oh, shit. Oh my god. I was like, I'm gonna die. I'm gonna kill myself right here. Because I couldn't escape that room. That plasma grenade did so much damage. Thank god I'm like as high level as I am. Alright, where's that other Mirelurk? Must have went around. Okay, he's moving around out here. Almost died like 3 times in the past couple episodes due to my grenades. It's terrible grenade throws. It's funny because I have really good grenade throws in Gears of War, but the grenade arc is, I don't know, a lot better in my opinion. Okay, so there was a terminal I could hack in one of these rooms. Where was it? Oh shit! Oh shit! Hello. He's like twirling through the air. I'm just a Mirelurk, and I'm sifting through the air. Oh my god, no way! He did so much damage! Wow! What? What? Oh, I should have just stunned him again. I should have instantly pulled out my chems and used them. God damn, dude. Oh, I gotta do all this shit again. Bullshit. That's fine, though. We'll just clear out this place really quick. Damn. Actually, I won't clear out this place. You already saw me clear out this place. We don't need to deal with that. Where's that exit at? In fact, where's that motherfucker at? There you are. You son of a bitch. I ran out of action points. Ow. Ow. Alright. I gotta stun you. And then throw... Oh, jeez! I was gonna say, throw a plasma grenade. I'm just a Mirelurk! Floating about. Yeah, what, are you stunned? Are you weak? Does it hurt you? You bastard. Ow! Ow! It hurts. Oh. Fuck you. You prick. Where's that 95 at? Left leg? Yeah, give me that left leg. Ugh. Douchebag. That's actually kind of cool, but that's not exactly what I want. Alright, alright, well, fuck that room. Where was that one room at? It had a terminal and I think, like, a locked door. Was it over here? Nope. It was down this hallway. Unidentified intruder detected. Shut up, Protectron. You're not helping. Maybe it's in here. It is in here. All right, let's unlock this door, shall we? We'll go through there, see what's in there, and then we'll head back, talk to what's-his-face. Call it an episode. It's going to be kind of a longer one, but I don't want it to be too long. It's becoming kind of unnecessarily long. That's why I'm not going to replay this part. Yeah, we got all these goodies in here. Ah. Oh my god. Fuck all this. Oh, this just leads you back up top. That's all. Okay, cool. I'm cool with it. Let's get out of here. Where's the exit? How did I get in here? Take me out of here. I don't need to see anything else. God damn it. Just get me out of here. Just get me out of here. Here we go. Woo! Oh, man. Next episode, we're going to do Battle of Bunker Hill. I think I'm going to take a little break from recording, though. It's like a half hour or something. So we're going to record for... I want to say a good hour and 15 minutes or so. Oh, shit! That thing followed me? Ah! Oh, my God! I freeze him. Oh, it didn't freeze him. Maybe you can't freeze these guys. He followed me, though. He was like, where you going, big boy? And I was like, away from you! That's for sure. That's cool, though. We got the bobblehead. We got the magazine. Oh, man. We're just... Ooh, we're almost done with this game. It's crazy. Getting so close. Oh, it's been such a long, wild ride, too. It's been insane. I crossed Poseidon Energy off my list. I have a little list of, like... areas to explore and cross Poseidon Energy off that list. So we are done there. Yeah. So we just got Adam Cat's garage, and that's the only thing left in this little section down here. And we mainly have just like four locations, I think, in this section to explore. So let's go back to the Institute. We'll talk to Isaac Douchebag over in Bioscience and see what's going on. Let him know that everything's A-okay. A-okay. Laser muskets were a pretty cool addition to this game. I do like them as a weapon. They're pretty interesting. Just overall. Okay, Bioscience. Perfect. Right next to it. Would you look at that? He's not in there, though, is he? He is up here in his room. I almost walked in there for no reason. It's probably like midnight or something here. Oh, he's above us, one more floor above us. I forget to look at the arrow, like, or I forget to notice the arrow, I should say, above the number when I'm going to a destination, an objective.
I delivered the seeds.
But good. I trust everything went smoothly.
You know it.
Yeah, pretty much.
Splendid, splendid. Here you are, then. Something to aid in your future missions, courtesy of the Bioscience Division. That will be all. Thank you very much.
Goodbye. 20 stim packs. Look at that. Nice. Very nice. Ouch. That hurt. All right. So cool. We finished off that quest. Next episode, we'll be doing the Battle of Bunker Hill. So be prepared for that. It's a pretty intense one. I'm going to end the episode here. Thank you guys for watching. Don't forget to leave a like and consider subscribing to the channel. My name is Brian, and hopefully I'll see you in the next one.